Next on Evening Magazine, the next Hans Christian Andersen.
Most everyone knows marionettes, and you may be familiar with Bunraku. It's a Japanese form of puppetry where the puppeteers appear on stage dressed totally in black. Well, here's a man who's combined the two and come up with something totally new. His name is Steve Overton, and he runs the Old World Puppet Theater.
How would you like to just step into a world of make-believe? Some of us, adults and children alike, can actually do that, thanks to the wizardry of Steve Overton.
Hey, now, Morty, this is very important.
Very
can they
very.
Blow like the wind?
That ain't gonna do it.
Okay, blow like a big wind!
I think they did that one fine.
I think so, too.
Okay. What time is it?
Lunchtime. Oh, we'll never have time to get away from here unless the children will help us.
We'll help.
Oh, Charlemagne's coming. Charlemagne's coming.
Enchantral, I'm back and I'm ready to eat. Oh, look. And dessert, too. Yum, yum.
Now, one, two, blow! I can't thank you children enough for all of your help. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Sterling, come on. Let's get out of here.
He calls it the Old World Puppet Theater, but really it's just another name for Steve's fertile imagination. His dozens of marionette characters who dangle their way through an assortment of dramas and adventures are actually the realization of a lifelong goal.
What was it that got you interested in puppets?
The first thing was really a puppet show in Germany. I crawled underneath the puppet stage, and the puppeteer did not kick me out. He just let me sit there and watch through the whole show.
How old were you?
Six. I watched him more than I watched the puppets, and I was fascinated about bringing something to life with your hands.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Definitely does.
As a master puppeteer, Steve not only operates his marionettes, but he also designs and builds them. The puppets are well detailed and the costumes are all carefully authentic. This means thousands of hours of painstaking work, but creating new worlds never did come easy.
What I want to be is the next Hans Christian Andersen. I have stories up inside my head that have forever been going round and round, and I write about them, and that's where the characters come from. So all of the characters that are in our shows are up in my head.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Howard Crowe sell at Fieldside. And today, a classic confrontation, youth versus experience. From the South, the knight, the irrepressible Sir Sampson. From the North, the young dragon in his first professional appearance.
Sam, can metal burn?
Why do you ask?
Because your pants are on fire.
Ah! Oh! Oh, my pants!
Sam, stop running! You're making it worse!
Oh, that's punching ouchie!
When you're on fire, you're supposed to stop running, drop to the ground, and roll your body! That will put the fire out! And now stop, drop, and roll!
Using an original puppeteering technique he calls Mariku, Steve Overton and his assistants perform in black. This is borrowed from the Japanese style called Bunraku, in which the puppeteers are supposed to be the puppet's shadows.
I took the technique of the black outfit and the shadow and turned it into my own theater with the marionettes so that I could take the marionettes out into the children. A lot of puppeteers say, don't touch the puppets, or sit on the children's laps or in the parents, and the whole audience is involved in it.
One, two, three.
Little!
When you're performing, there's a real magic of going from your hands into the beam and down into the string. The puppet will walk over and pick something up or sit down, and the foot crosses over, and it looks real. That's a real thrill, because you have created something right there out of nothing.
And that's the magic of the Old World Puppet Theater.